أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم حمدا لا يتناهى. ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. جزاكم الله خير وبارك الله فيكم. أسأل الله bless you and أسأل الله give you more بركة. And أسأل الله give us more بركة and more رزق. And أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى make it easy for us to do more righteous good deeds. And أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى to bless and to give more blessing to the one who is helping of making this program successful inshallah. Still with Al-Kaba'ir is a major sin. And it is the duty of every Muslim to learn about the major sin in order to avoid it. We still, alhamdulillah, now in Kabira, now 39, means already explained 38 Kabira. Some of our own brother and the people who was following us through their life, they said it clearly that we didn't know a lot of those that it is a major sin. We know that it is a sin, but we didn't know that it is major sin, because some of it these days become very regular and become very common and become very normal to a lot of people. For that, if you do not study it and you do not go on, and this is one of the books, I'm not saying this is old, this is one of the books we'll talk about Al-Kaba'ir for Imam al-Dhahabi. The last time was Kabir number 38 was Ta'allum al-ilm al-dini lil-dunya wa kitmanu al-ilm, learning the religious knowledge only for the sake of dunya. Learning the religious knowledge for money. His intention for money, his intention for dunya, his intention for position, his intention to be something in between the people, his own ego. This is Allah will not accept it from him, and he will never get any benefit of that knowledge. Because one part of the knowledge to know that when you do anything, do it sincerely for Allah alone. Go back to Kabir number 37, was about show off, which is the disease of al-Asr, disease of these days, of the time. That show off with your good deeds, show off with your salah, show off with your ilm, show off with all of your life, wal-'iyaz billah, illa man rahim rabbi. Except if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful to some people, then Allah will make their heart, their mind, their intention clearly and purely to Allah Azza wa Jal only. And we said, the last time we talk about that, Imam al-Dhahabi start with Surah Fatir, verse number 28, when Allah said, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. A very huge certificate to everyone who have even some knowledge. Because I told you the last time, witness of Rasulullah, testify of Rasulullah, whoever have the knowledge and the memorize the first six surah of the Quran, Al-Baqarah, Al-Imran, Al-Nisa, and Al-Fatiha also, Rasulullah testified to him as a alim. Doesn't need anyone to testify to him or to deny it also. Rasulullah said it, that he is alim, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hadith in the silsila sahiha for Imam Al-Albani. Here Allah Azza wa Jal say about those alims, the only one from my creation, only one from my slaves, fear Allah is those ulama. A huge certificate, the only one fear Allah from the creation of Allah is the alim. There is no doubt. Alim of the Quran and Sunnah of Rasulullah. Then we moved after that, that Allah take a covenant with those ulama that must make it clear to the people. Never hide anything, not for the sake of dunya, not fear about my salary, not fear about the people will get angry. Let the people get angry. As long as you are in the right way, as long as Quran and Sunnah, as long as it is, make it clear to the people. Because look, as I explained the last time, if you hide the salah because of the people does not pray, and you do not talk about zakah because of the people will get angry, they don't pay zakah. You do not talk about girlfriend and boyfriend because some people have girlfriend and boyfriend. You do not talk about this. You will cancel the whole religion. What else left for you to talk about? You will cancel the whole religion. Then you will try politics and you will try going around. And this is the, what is coming next about the khiyana, about the betraying, about going around. But in Arabic and Urdu also, makr. Walayazu billah. There is hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Nasa'i. And Imam al-Zahabi mentioned it, but mentioned it in the next one, which it is al-Mannan. The next Kabir al-Mannan, the one who reminds the people about his favor. You do something for the sake of Allah at the beginning, or sincerely. But maybe the intention later change. Then he comes, look, do you remember? I am the one who did so and so. I am the one who built this masjid. I am the one who did the... A'uzu billah, ya akhi. You already destroy all of your good deeds. He mentioned in this part, but what it was about in Nasa'i, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يدخل الجنة خب. Will not enter الجنة خب. What is خب? المكر والماكر, المخادع, الخبيث, المحتال. The one who go around. The one who is not straight. The one who is betraying. The one who is evil. The one who says something and do opposite of it. The one who have a tricks. The one who always deal with the people with a trick way. And he think all the people, as I told you before Al-Isha, all the people is like him. And everybody, Allah will expose him to everyone. Everyone around him will know that this man is a tricky man. This man is a cheater man. This man is a betrayer man. The only one who will never know about himself except if Allah be merciful to him is him himself. He will not know about himself. He will think that this is okay and this is good. Some of them, they will think that he's an angel. He's one of the angels, which it is completely wrong. When Allah loves you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will make you to know your own mistake, then you'll try to deal with it. Mistakes and wrong way is like a disease. If you don't know about it, you will never deal with it. You will never treat it. But if you know about it, then it will benefit you. And if Allah loves you and Allah be merciful to you. We moved after that to that do not learn knowledge for show off. Do not learn knowledge for argue. Do not learn knowledge to attract the mind of the people to you that I know, while other people doesn't know. Learn the knowledge sincerely for Allah Azza wa Jal. Do not give fatwa when you don't know. Half of the knowledge if you say I don't know, if really you don't know. But giving fatwa up and down, left and right, to make yourself something, this is not allowed. Today, inshallah, I already explained too much about it last time. Today is about Kabira number 39, which it is al-khiyana, khiyanatul amana, betraying or cheating of the trust. Betraying of the trust. Al-amana is the trust, and I'll explain what it is. Betraying it or cheating the people. Some people, they think that it is something great. When you cheat the people, then you get something out of cheating from them, money or property or whatever. They think that, oh, and they are proud of doing it. He mentioned to the others that he is doing cheating, and he is doing betraying, and he is doing makr, and he is doing a crooked way. And feeling happy. You should feel sad and bad about it. You should not feel good. For that al-amana, what is al-amana? The thing is entrusted to you. When I give something and I say, this is amana with you. This entrust thing in Arabic, same amana. It's not only giving anything. Also another meaning for it, honesty. This is part of the amana. Another meaning for amana also. All the duties Allah Azza wa Jal order you to do it, it's in amana also. That means here, either the amana between you and Allah, or the amana between you and the people, for that never betray the amana between you and Allah when you disobey Allah. When you disobey also Rasulullah. The ayah saying that, Surah Al-Anfal, Surah number 8, ayah number 27. Listen carefully. Allah Azza wa Jal said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تخونوا الله والرسول وتخونوا أماناتكم وأنتم تعلمون. What's the meaning of this ayah? O you who believe, never ever betray Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Never also, it's the next word, وتخونوا, comes from khiyana, betraying. وتخونوا أماناتكم, never knowingly betraying your trust. Never knowingly, never intentionally betraying your trust. This ayah have a reason of revelation. But in Arabic we say that العموم اللفظي نأخذه بعموم اللفظي لا بخصوص السبب. Even some of the ayat have a specific reason for revelation. We are not only connected it and limited it with that reason. As long as the text is general, it will be applied forever, for everything. What does it mean? In Ibn Kathir and Imam Al-Wahidi and many others, they bring, and here in Imam Al-Zahabi, he bring the reason of revelation. This ayah revealed about Abu Lubaba, Ibn Al-Munzir. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent to him to Bani Qurayza, Bani Qurayza betrayed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam do hisar around them. It was the army, send army to them. Abu Lubaba ibn al-Munzir, he went to Bani Qurayza when Rasulullah did that with them. And his kids and his money, his kids and his family, I mean, was with them in Bani Qurayza. Then they asked, Bani Qurayza asked Abu Lubaba, and they said to him, what do you think about dealing with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad and making Sa'd as judge between? Abu Lubaba ashara ila halqihi annahu al-dhabhu. فلا تفعلوا. He said, do not do. He will kill you. He was a Muslim. Abu Lubaba was a Muslim. And he should say the right. But he now, he himself, realized it. He said, فما تحركت أو بالنص فما زالت قدماي من مكاني حتى عرفت أني خنت الله ورسوله. He said, my feet does not move one step except from there after I said that to them. Except I know that I already betray Allah and already betray Rasulullah when I said them to that. When I said to them that. This is one of the narration about Abu Lubaba ibn al-Munzir. Al-Imam also, ibn al-Zahabi, he does not mention another hadith in al-Bukhari. In al-Sahihain actually, in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. Hatib ibn Abi Balta'ah in al-Bukhari, in Bab al-Jihad wa-Sir, and in Bab al-Jasus, the spy. If you want to look at it, hadith number 3007, and page number 154, hadith number also 3081, and 6939. This is in al-Bukhari. In Muslim, chapter of Fada'il al-Sahaba, superiority of the Sahaba, hadith number 2494. What happened? It was Hatib ibn Abi Balta'ah. عن عبيد بن أبي رافع قال سمعت علي سيدنا علي رضي الله عنه قال بعثني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رسول الله تشوز سيدنا علي عن الزبير عن المقداد three of them سيدنا علي الزبير عن المقداد and he said انطلقوا حتى تأتوا روضة خاخ he said go until you reach a place this place name روضة خاخ فإن بها ضعينة أي امرأة ومعها كتاب there was a woman there. And this woman, and this is one of the miracles of Rasulullah, that Allah told him of something, he doesn't see it by himself, but Allah told him. That woman, she have a letter. This letter was written from Hatib ibn Abi Balta'ah. He said, bring it back from me. When they went, at the beginning, she denied. She said, no, I don't have anything. When the beginning, Sayyidina Ali, and Sayyidina Zubair, and Al-Muqdad ibn Amr, they meet her, she said, no, she denied it. فقلنا لها أخرج الكتاب أو لنلقين الثياب أخرج الكتاب أو لنلقين الثياب Either you get the book to give it to us or we will search your clothes in order to find it, to get it out. She said no, I will give it was making it in her braid. She was making it in her braid, in her hair. And amazing, she was not Muslim. And this is for the sisters behind. She said to them, turn your face. In order to uncover herself in order to get it out. She doesn't want them to look to her. Because at their time, Only the slaves is on who can uncover the rape. The free woman does not do that. Only the slaves is on who uncover their hair. The free woman, she usually cover herself as order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But let us go on. Then she bring it, and Sayyidina Ali and the others, they bring it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was written in it from Hatib ibn Abi Balta'a, this letter from Hatib ibn Abi Balta'a, to some people of the Mushrik in Mecca, the summary of it, he was telling them about some of the intention of Rasulullah of opening Mecca. It was at the year of opening Mecca. But he was telling them about some of the intention of Rasulullah, what he will do. And this betraying, he should not do that. He is a Muslim. But he was doing that thing in sending a letter. Rasulullah asked him, Hatib, why you do that? This is completely wrong and you know that. Why you do it? Then he said, Ya Rasulullah, do not hurry to judge me. But part of the hadith قال, أحببت إذا فاتني النسب فيهم أن أتخذ عندهم يدا يحمون بها قرابتي وما فعلت ذلك كفرا ولا ارتدادا ولا رضا بالكفر بعد الإسلام فقال رسول الله قد صدقكم فأنزل الله الآية. He said, حطب نبي بلتع يا رسول الله, do not hurry to judge me. I'll explain it. I am from Quraysh, but I have no blood relation with any one of them. In order for any one of them to protect me, he said, your people, the Muhajirin with you, a lot of them have already some of their families there, some of their relative, blood relation, and they will protect him if we go to them. But for me, I don't have anyone. For that, I was trying to do them favor in order to, if I go, I have already my own family and my own kids with them to protect them with my family. From them, I did that only to protect my family, not to do it as a kufra or getting out of Islam, not to be murtad, and not to be happy with the kufr or being doing something against the Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he is telling you the truth. Allah revealed the ayah, do not betray Allah, do not betray Rasulullah, do not betray amanatikum. Imam al-Wahidi, firstly Ibn Kathir, he does not mention it, but this out, Ibn Kathir قال, وَالصَّحِيحُ أَنَّ الْآيَةَ عَامَّ وإن صح أنها نزلت بسبب خاص فالأخذ بعموم اللفظ لا بخصوص السبب. He said, whatever يعني صحيح and correct is, this ayah is in general, is not only because of this reason of حاطب ابن أبي لبابة or حاطب ابن أبي بلتعة. In general, do not betray Allah, do not betray Rasulullah. When you disobey Allah or disobey Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, this betraying, and this whatever between you and Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Also for the other people, when you cheat, when you betray, when you say something and do something else, tricks, evil plots, all of this makr, khida', cheating and betraying, this is completely forbidden and one of the major sin in Islam. For that Allah say, do not betray Allah and do not betray Rasulullah. Also, do not betray the amana. The amana is one part of it also for Allah and Rasulullah with the duties. And the amana is when you entrust somebody, giving him something, said, please keep this. Even it is not material. Even whatever you give him is a word. Remember when I told you before, some of the people professional, you give him some word and say, keep it with you. Never mention me, never mention my name. This is for your own benefit. Then he goes to the other, to everybody. He mentioned it to everyone. This is betraying. Then when he mentioned what he do, he said, please, he already asked me not to say to nobody. You already betray and you asked him to be honest. Then wal'ayazu billah, if the same person say, it will go on and on and on and on. The only one doesn't know is the one who started. For that, Allah Azza wa Jal ordered us not to do that. Imam al-Wahidi, he mentioned already about Abu Lubab ibn al-Munzir. Then, disobeying is khiyana coming from وَتَخُونُوا أَمَانَاتِكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ عَطْفٌ عَلَى النَّهِي أي لا تخونوا الأمانة. قال ابن عباس, الأمانات الأعمال التي ائتمن الله عليها العباد, يعني الفرائض, فلا تنتقضوها أو لا تنقضوها. ابن عباس said, one of the opinion about this ayah, that الأمانات, الأمانة, other than the trust, the things you give your trust about it, money or property or land or whatever it is also that between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever Allah order you, one of it is al-fara'id, what Allah order you to do. Salah, zakah, siyam, coming later. Imam al-Kalbi, qala, amma khiyanatullah wa rasulu fa ma'asiyatuhuma. Betraying Allah and Rasulullah is when you disobey them. خيانه الامانه فكل واحد مؤتمن على ما افترض الله عليه ان شاء خانها وان شاء اداها ولا يطلع عليه احد الا الله. Is it part of it? Must the people know this? Imam al-Kalbi saying that when you disobey Allah, this is betraying. When you disobey Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, for those who insist on doing the bid'ah, betraying to Allah. Because bid'ah replacing a sunnah. Our religion is complete and perfect, right? When you do innovation, you are putting it in a place of sunnah because this is complete and perfect. You are saying my way is better than the way of Allah or better than the way of Rasulullah. People will not say it verbally, but they will do it practically. And it should not be done at all. Also, وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّهَا أَمَانَةٌ مِّنْ غَيْرِ شُبْهَةٍ. While you are knowingly knows about it, that it is amana and trust, and you should not do that. In Surah Yusuf, Surah number 12, verse number 52, what Allah said, Allah will never ever guide those who betray. Allah will never ever guide those who do evil plots. Secretly evil plot, let us do so and so and so on, push the people against each other and talking bad about them and put them down. Allah will never raise you up when you put others down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي كَيْدَ الْخَائِنِينَ. Allah will never ever guide and make it to be effective the evil plots of those who do the plots. Do you know what Allah said? وَلَا يَحِيقُ الْمَكْرُ السَّيِّئُ إِلَّا بِأَهْلِهِ. Evil blood will never destroy except the one who do it. Allah will return it against him. وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ. They do evil blood. And they do a lot of makr. And betraying. And evil. But the blood of Allah, the plan of Allah, the best translation. The plan of Allah is the best. Plan of Allah will destroy their plan. But this is when you trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you depend upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you do your tawakkul upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال معناها معنى الآية Allah will not guide them. Allah does not guide the plot of the betrayers. That Allah will not guide them to do. And Allah will open it. Allah will expose it. Allah will make the people to know about it. What Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said? And narrated by Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim. Ayatul munafiqi thalath. The sign of the hypocrite. Hypocrite is not a mu'min. There is no any doubt about that. Hypocrite, and if he insists and believe in it, it could get him out of Islam. The sign of the hypocrite, the munafiq, is a three. Is a haddata kazab. When he speaks, he lies. And he has excuse for his lies. There is no any doubt. وَإِذَا وَعَدَ أَخْلَفْ. When he promised, he break his promise. Say something few days after it. Wallahi, sometimes few seconds. He will change his word right away. Oh no, because of this and that, then he change. When you promise, do it. Otherwise, before you promise, think about it. If you are able to do, say. If you are not able, don't promise. Third one, which it is related to ours. وَإِذَا تُمِنَ خَانْ. When he entrusted, he betrayed. When he entrusted with any kind of amana, amana with Allah or amana with the people, he is betrayer. He will break it. In another narration for Imam Muslim, قال آيات المنافق ثلاث. The sign of the منافق is a three. وإن صام وصلى وزعم أنه مسلم. Rasulullah said it. Even he pray and even he do fasting and even his claim of that he is a Muslim, he is منافق. He is a hypocrite. Also another hadith of Rasulullah narrated by Imam Ahmad wal-Bazzar wa-Ibn Hibban an Anas wa-Tabarani an Ibn Umar. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, la imana liman la amanata lah, wa la deena liman la ahda lah. No iman, he is not a mu'min. For the one who does not, liman la amanata lah, who does not keep the trust, who does not keep the amana, who does not break it, who does not betray, with another way. No iman for the betrayers. He is not a mu'min. And no deen, have no deen. Means completely zero. Have no deen, no religion. The one who have no covenant. He betrayed, he break it, he does not keep it. وَالْخِيَانَةُ قَبِيحَةٌ فِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَبَعْضُهَا أَشَرُّ مِنْ بَعْضٍ وَلَيْسَ مَنْ خَانَكَ في فلس كمن خانك في أهلك أو مالك أو ارتكب العظائم ضدك. He said, in here, that the خيانة and the betraying is not the same level. Some of it is higher than the others. And he gave example. If somebody betray you in 1 cent, in $1, will never be equal to the one who betray you in with your family. Who betray you as he say exactly with your money. Or he betray you in a great, he commit a great and major sin against you. In Tirmizi, even somebody betray you is not allowed for you to betray him. Suppose somebody he did trick against you. Is it allowed for you to betray him and go behind him and do the tricks? It's not allowed in Islam. Listen to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال أدي الأمانة إلى من ائتمن. نرد بالإمام الترمذي. ولا تخن من خانك. Give the أمانة to the one who entrusted you. When he needed, give it back to him. And especially with the yatim, the orphan. There is no doubt to everyone. But with the orphan. Why with the orphan? Orphan always the one who his father died while he's young. And he live a property. Then you take care of the property. Do not swallow it. Because he is young, doesn't know anything. 10 acre, 20 acre, 30 acre. When he grow, become 20 years. Already 20 years passed, nobody knows nothing. Oh, your father does leave only 1 acre, half. Out of 100. A'uzu billahi minash shaitan rajeem. It will never benefit you. You will take only your good deeds with you in your grave. Betraying the amana is one of the major sins in Islam. For that here, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, give the amana. Now we know what is the amana. If something you are entrusted to keep it, to save it, to protect it. Even to, in your businesses. Do not betray in your business. And, ولا تخن من خانك. Do not betray the one who already betrayed you. Means do not take revenge. He betray me, okay. Let him see who I am. أعوذ بالله يا أخي. I'll be worse than him. No, you should not be worse than him. You should deal with Allah. Ask Allah to forgive. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah will forgive you. In another hadith narrated by Imam Ahmad, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم يطبع المؤمن على كل شيء ليس الخيانة والكذب. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, a believer nature disposition can be a believer nature disposition, your nature can be include some of the mistakes. Can be include some. So I like being coward. This is Rasulullah say, could be coward. Like sometimes you fear, other than the shirki fear. I already explained it. Sometimes you will have some mistake, Rasulullah say, but the believer will never ever be treachery, be betrayer, and will never lie. Believer is not a betrayer. Believer is not lying. That means when you lie, when you betray, are you a believer or hypocrite? Answer me. Hypocrite, there is no any doubt. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, Allah Azza wa Jal said, and this hadith, نربى الإمام أبو داود والحاكم الإمام حكم سيد صحيح. يقول الله, Allah Azza wa Jal said, أنا ثالث الشريكين ما لم يخن أحدهما صاحبه. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, if there is two partners, if there is two partners in a business, two partners in a land, two partners in a house, two partners in a money, two partners in anything in general, Allah said, I am the third one of them. Look, if Allah is the third one of two people, barakah and rahmah and successful, Allah said, I am the third, as long as no one of them betrays the other. If any one of them betrays the other, even a small, then you know, sometimes you will betray by your eye. By your eye, while you don't know. Looking in a thing is not yours, from behind. Some people professional, they have PhD. Master degree in cheating and going makr and khida. He just left. Oh, let us see what he has. Subhanallah, this is betraying. You should not. You know the hadith of Rasulullah when a man was looking from the door. Rasulullah was a little bit waiting. And for the salah, he does not come. One of the sahaba waiting a long time, he said, let me see if Rasulullah is coming. He does not have any bad intention. If he's coming or not, you know at their time, the door is only just a piece of wood beside each other and have gaps in between, right? Then he was looking to see Rasulullah coming or not. At that time, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was combing his hair with iron comb. With a comb made out of iron. Rasulullah said after that when he came to know, if I know, I will spoil it and put it in his eye, spoil his eye and no dear for him. No diya means I will not pay him any money because إنما جعل الاستئذان من أجل النظر. Allah ordered us to take permission before we enter because of the eye. For that, when you already looked inside, as if you already enter inside, is not allowed for you to do that. For that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said also in another hadith, أول ما يرفع من الناس الأمانة وآخر ما يبقى الصلاة ورب مصل لا خير فيه. The first thing will be raised up from between the people is الأمانة. Is the trust, honesty, being honest. Being honest, not betrayer. Being honest, not cheater. Being honest, not a hypocrite. Which one you like? In front of Allah, the day of judgment, to be honest or to be betrayer? Answer me, please. Honest. To be honest or to be munafiq? Honest. To be trustworthy? Trustworthy for the sake of Allah, not for the sake of the people. Or to be betraying and going around and doing wrong and make the people, all of them, they will hate you. Nobody will like anyone who is betrayer. Nobody will like anyone who is cheater at all. For that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, the first thing will be raised up from between the people, trustworthy, being honest. And the last thing will stay with the people is the prayer. And Rasulullah said, وَرُبَّ مُصَلِّنْ لَا خَيْرَ فِي. May be somebody praying, but there is no any good in him. Maybe somebody is praying, but there is no any good in him. We ask Allah to save us from being like that. Say, Amen. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم نريد بالإمام أبو داود والنسائي وابن ماجه قال إياكم والخيانة فإنها بئسة البطانة. I am warning you against being betraying. I am warning you against being betraying. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, and he said, is the worst thing to have. البطانة in Arabic, do you know the ruler, the حاكم, the judge, the أمير. Allah already, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam already said, there is some people will be around him. Some of those people, it's the name al-bitana now. Al-bitana, do you know, inside of your clothes, when it is for making you warm, if it is cold, this is its name al-bitana. Means the one who is very near to the ruler, very near to the judge, very near to the president, whoever in any position. Some of these people, Rasulullah say, some of them, they will give him good advice. They will be good to him. They will try to make him in a straight way. But some of them is the worst. They will always give him a bad advice. Will always make him to be in a wrong way. Will always push him to do wrong. This is a bit, the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, warning this kind of people. Say, do not betray. Because the worst thing to be, betrayer. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام narrated by Imam Muslim من حديث عياض هكذا أهل النار. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describing the people of hellfire. And he mentioned, hadith is long, mention of them, ذكر منهم رجلا لا يخفى له طمع وإن دق إلا خانة. رجل لا يخفى له طمع وإن دق إلا خانة. What Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, a man who is greedy, very greedy, and does not come upon even a very small thing without his betraying it, and without his cheating in it. Means what? Even the one who betrayed will become his nature. It is a big thing, he will betray. It is a small thing, he will betray. For that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were warning us that one of the people of hellfire is the one who does that. Ibn Mas'ud, he said, and this is narrated by Imam Ahmad wal Bayhaqi mawquf, قال يؤتى يوم القيامة بصاحب الأمان الذي خان فيها. At the day of judgment, and I remember there is another hadith that he will have a flag. Everyone who betrays will have a flag over his head. And it will be written in it, هَذِهِ خِيَانَةُ فُلَانِ. This is a betraying of so and so. But this one is different. He will bring the one who betrays in the dunya. And they will say to him, return the amana. Return whatever you take. Return whatever you betray in it. He will say, يَا رَبْ أَنَّ لِي هَذَا وَقَدْ ذَهَبَتِ الدُّنْيَا. How I'll do that? And there is no any dunya, no more dunya. No more money, no more gold, no more silver. قال فتمثل له كهيئتها يوم أخذها في قعر جهنم. It will be shown to him at the bottom of Jahannam exactly what he said at the same day he did. But instead of dunya, it will be in Jahannam, in hellfire. Then will be saying to him, انزل إليها فأخرجها. Go down to it and bring it back. Bring this amana, whatever he takes, from the end of Jahannam. قَالَ فَيَنْزِلُ إِلَيَّا فَيَحْمِلُهَا عَلَىٰ عَاتِقِهِ. He will go down in Jahannam and he will put it over his shoulder. وَهِيَ أَثْقَلُ مِنْ جِبَالِ الدُّنْيَا. Even it was in the dunya very small, it will be heavy upon his shoulder more than the mountains of the dunya. Very heavy upon him. حَتَّى إِذَا ظَنَّ أَنَّهُ نَاجٍ هَوَتْ وَهَوَى فِي أَثَرِهَا إِلَىٰ أَبْعَدِ الْأَبْعَدِينَ. هَوَى فِي أَثَرِهَا أَبَدَ الْأَبْدِينَ. Until he will think that he already going near to get out of Jahannam, that Allah will make him, and this amana because so heavy, he will fall down in Jahannam, and he will repeat that again and again and again. Because of what he betrayed in dunya. For that, Allah and Rasulullah saying to us, be honest. Never betray. Never do any cheating. Be straight. Never go around. It will never benefit you in dunya, and it will never benefit you in the hereafter, will never benefit you in your grave, will never benefit you by any way at all. Ibn Mas'ud, other than the hadith I started with, I will complete it. Rasulullah said, the one who do makr, the one who do betraying, the one who do cheating, the one who is evil, the one who is muhtal, is a tricker, he always loves to do tricks. This is will never enter al-Jannah. Then the rest of the hadith, wala bakhilun wala mannan. Not the miserly one, and not the one who reminds the people about his favor. Remember I did so and so, remember I did this and that, and bringing all of the pictures, and doing all of the photocopy of everything, should not. Deal with Allah Azza wa Jal. You did it for Allah, keep it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't need to remind anybody with anything. Allah Azza wa Jal remember it. Allah Azza wa Jal knows it. If you do it for him, wallahi by Allah will give you better than and more than what you deserve. InshaAllah, Imam ibn Mas'ud, and I'll finish with it. Imam ibn Mas'ud, he said, As-salatu amana, salah is amana. Wal-wudu'u amana, wudu is amana. Do your salah perfect and complete. Do not cheat. And do not show off with it. Do not show off in front of the people. You do it very perfect and very good. Between you and your alone, at the end of the day, Zuhr was Asr was Maghrib was Isha in 1 second. Subhanallah, you're looking at your own self. Some people, they do that. If you are doing, stop. In front of people, you make it perfect and long and good. Some people, they bend themselves like that because to show the khushu'ah. That they are all perfect. Sahaba, he's a prophet. Astaghfirullah. For that wrong. But if he's alone, he will do the 4 rak'ah in less than 2 seconds. Allahu Akbar, Sami Allahu al-Muhammad, finish. Wassalamu alaykum. First taslima, in the, while he's sitting, the second taslima, he's already in another room. Subhanallah. Deal with Allah. Know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to know al-muraqabah. Muraqabah is to deal with Allah Azza wa Jal and to know that Allah is watching you all the time. Salah is amana. Wudu is amana. وَيْلٌ لِلْعَقَابِ مِنَ النَّارِ. Woe to the heels, the end of your leg. Heels from hellfire. When you do the wudu and the water does not cover the heels of it. For that do your wudu perfect and complete in order for your salah to be acceptable. Also, already we take related to the wudu. We take already one of the major sins when you urinate and you does not protect yourself from coming back of some of the urine to your clothes. Especially while you're standing. If you know if you urinate while you're standing, it will make your clothes dirty or some of it will come back to you while you don't see it. Better to sit. Better to sit down. Because the hadith itself, for those who was having azab in the grave, one of them, because of the namima, transfers the word to the people to spoil them and giving them wrong information. The second one, he does not to nourish. لا يستتروا, لا يستبرئوا. لا يستتر, he does not save himself from the coming back of the urine against his clothes or body or whatever. لا يستبرئوا, he does not clean himself with the water after he finishes the urine. Here, wudu is amana. Shower is amana. Especially when you take the shower after the janab. Think everybody knows the janabah, the relation with the wife. Then you should make sure that the water cover from the top all the way till the end. From your hair to your toes. Completely. Not even a single small part of your body does not covered with the water. Or that also, قَالَ وَالْوَزْنُ أَمَانَ وَالْكَيْلُ أَمَانَ. Measure is a trust. Do not cheat in it. Giving full weight is a trust. Never cheat in it. وأعظم ذلك أعظم الأمانات الودائع. As he say exactly, the greatest one of the all of the trusts is when somebody trusts you for something. Somebody trusts you for money, for even a word. Even in your eyes does not have a value. Be honest, never be betrayer. InshaAllah, the next Kabira number 40, will be about Al-Mannan. Al-Mannan is the one who reminds the people about his favors. This is one of the major sins in Islam. Should not do that. Because remember when I said, before you do any good deeds, this is a good deed. Before it, make it for Allah. During it, make it for Allah, sincerely for Allah. After it, till the day of judgment, keep it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. For that, when you remind the people about your favor, there is some ayat about it, there is some ahadith about it. Inshallah, we will go on with it the next halaqa and remind you tomorrow, inshallah, will be the also another dars from 7 to 8 after Al Maghrib and will be about it Tawheed. Very important. Whoever, even you attended before, come back again, inshallah, tomorrow, Sunday from 7 p.m. after Al Maghrib till 8 o'clock. Then after 8, we'll do the Isha, inshallah. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا اللهم كفر عنا سيئاتنا اللهم توفنا مع الأبرار اللهم أرحنا وفرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار وأرحنا وفرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين فوق كل أرض وتحت كل سماء يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين فوق كل أرض وتحت كل سماء يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعلنا وأهالينا وبلادنا وبلاد المسلمين في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتأييدك يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر من نصرنا واخذل من خذلنا وقوي إيماننا وارفع درجاتنا وتقبل صلاتنا اللهم اشف مرضى المسلمين أجمعين اللهم اشف مرضى المسلمين أجمعين اللهم اشف مرضى المسلمين أجمعين اللهم رب الناس مذهب الباس اشفي وأنت الشافي لا شفاء إلا شفاءك شفاء لا يغادر سقما نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يشفي كل مريض يا حي يا قيوم يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اشف مرضى المسلمين أجمعين نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل اللهم ارزقنا قلوبا تقية نقية لا كافرة ولا شقية وأرحنا وفرحنا واسترنا ولا تفضحنا اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم ارزقنا صدقة جارية وتقبلها منا اللهم ارزقنا صدقة جارية وتقبلها منا وارزقنا علما ينتفع به وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا اللهم ارزقنا علما ينتفع به وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وارزقنا ذرية صالحة تدعو لنا يا حي يا قيوم وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وجزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم and remember me always in your dua والسلام عليكم